WinPatrol 2009 is a behavior-based program that has little or no conflict with your existing security programs, and it is not a replacement for antivirus or anti-malware programs, but to add an extra layer of security to what you already have. In your taskbar, you'll have this little icon, which is Scotty, who will be patrolling your system. When you open WinPatrol, it barks at you. And it would do the same when changes are made that shouldn't be, where additions are made with programs running and whatever. This will show you programs that are running, and you can disable them, you can move to delayed start, you can enable them. It gives you an idea of what is running on your computer. You can display secret startup locations, which is for more advanced users. And you can check on the date that it was first detected and stop the process running if it isn't needed. Delayed start. You can set a time for the delay. We make that 10 minutes and apply. That's it. ActiveX controls show you the ActiveX that are registered to be used by Internet Explorer. You can enable or disable them through this panel. IE Helpers watches the IE Helper programs or links that are installed and available to Internet Explorer. And again, you can remove them if you don't need them. If they shouldn't be there, simply click remove it. Schedule tasks will show you what tasks are scheduled to run through the Windows Task Scheduler. Services. This watches the services that are installed on your computer. And again, you can go through the first detected date and check them out. If it shouldn't be there, you can get further information on it by clicking on Info. Active tasks. This shows what is currently running on your computer, and again, you can get the first detected date, which is very useful for malware removal. You can kill the task. Just highlight kill. That's it. Cookies. This will display cookies that are on your machine at the present time. You can remove the unchecked, or you can check them and remove them. It's entirely your choice. This works on Internet Explorer and Firefox. File types. Here you will find the different extensions like BAT, EXE, EML, and what they're for. Here it will show you the programs they're related to. Hidden files. Most of these are legitimate files, and you have to be very careful if you're going to remove any. Leave this to people who know what they're doing. Again, you can check the last written date for validity. Recent. Now, through this, you can find programs that have downloaded and installed themselves that you didn't want. And you can delete the file on reboot, which is a great way of clearing malware off an infected machine. Plus, if you click here, you can upgrade to WinPatrol Plus. You can check for a new version. Options. You can create a WinPatrol log, which will open up a browser window showing a lot of information. You can create a spreadsheet report, a hijack log. This is very useful for hijack this, and you can then post it into one of the various forums that will read the log for you. You can view your host file. Make sure these two are ticked. Detect changes to IE home and search pages, and warn if changes are made to your host and critical system files. These are very important. Also these, track changes in restoration file. Play sounds, that's optional, but it can be a good idea, depending on your level of experience. Automatically run WinPatrol when computer starts. I think that this is essential, because it constantly monitors. You can change to the original Scotty taskbar icon, which is a little dog. You can view the history, export the settings, and restore all delayed, which will take the delayed start back to the startup programs. Now if I add a program which has not been set to run, and close that, go back to active tasks, sorry, startup programs. Here's the warning: new program alert, and a shortcut to this program has been added to the startup folder. Do you want to allow it, yes or no? This is the information you will get when something is installed on your computer. So the choice is yours. If it's a malware infection, you will go with no. If it's a program you know, you tick yes. So I will move this to the delayed start, and I will change its time to 5 minutes after boot. And this can speed up your boot times. It's an excellent program. There's three versions. There's the free version, the paid version, which is a one-off payment, and there's the portable version, which is great for troubleshooting. If you want any more information, check out my blog, which is Free PC Security, and you can find it at freepcsecurity.co.uk.